Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Panthers going up against the Broncos. Now let's head down to Jim Nantz and Phil Simms for today's matchup.
Broncos, Panthers on EA Sports. We welcome you to Santa Clara, California for today's game. And you've heard it so many times. You've just heard it all over again. It doesn't get any bigger than this. So if you're one of the players, how do you handle the bigness of a game like this?
Well, so many things right there in that question, Jim. One, the players, they're used to being on stage. They love the spotlight shined upon them. They've learned it from high school to college to now to the pros. But I'll say this about the Super Bowl. Here we are, Super Bowl 50. Look how far it's come since Super Bowl I. It's hard to believe it's that big. And for the players and coaches out there today, I'll just say this. I promise you, if it's the first time you've been in this game, it's going to live up to everything you ever dreamed about it being.
Now we go down to field level as Danielle Bellini has more on today's matchup.
Thanks, guys. Super Bowl 50 is a very special milestone for the NFL. Super Bowl I was played back in 1967 at the LA Coliseum. As you recall, the Green Bay Packers beat the Kansas City Chiefs on that day. But I'm sure neither of those teams could have imagined the Super Bowl growing to be as big as it is today, guys. That being said, we've got two teams out here who desperately want to make history by winning the Super Bowl tonight to ensure they're the ones that are remembered and that everyone is talking about 50 years from now. Back to you guys.
Danielle, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the field. And Graham Gano looks ready to get this one underway. The Super Bowl is officially underway. A champion will be crowned. Caldwell is going to drop to a knee here, so this will come out to the 20. One of the biggest icons ever at quarterback, Peyton Manning. The Broncos come to the line with a bunch set. First down at the 20. And it's swatted away. He has blossomed into a big-time receiver in this game, Emmanuel Sanders.
Well, it's not about just the offense. Oh, the offense gives him those numbers. He has shown wherever he plays, no matter who the coach or the quarterback is, he can get it done.
The Panthers with a nickel look here on defense. Second and 10. Anderson's taking the handoff.
The Panthers' defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle the runner for a loss.
Loss of 5 on the play. Third down. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Peyton Manning looking down the field. Unable to complete that one. And that's a very quick 3 and out.
The Broncos really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete. it'll be Colquitt back to punt.
Gent will try his return. That picks up 7.
He is the first player with 10,000 passing yards and over 1,000 rushing yards in a first 3-season career. Quarterback Cam Newton. The Panthers in the pistol. First down at the 46. Miller's the one who made the big stop.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped.
Second and 12. Stewart's going to take the handoff now. The running back position will be handled today by Jonathan Stewart out of Oregon.
Well, it seems like Jonathan Stewart's been in the NFL for about 15 years, and he just keeps running the football, having success. I like the way he runs. I like his style, and he is productive.
Third and 8. Olsen's got it, and a first.
Now look at all these great tight ends in the NFL now. Makes me think of the NBA. These are power forwards who said, to heck with that. They want to be pass catchers, and they're good at it.
Set up now at the 42.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
Stewart's going to secure the handoff. Stewart's tackled down at the 31.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line. First down at the 31. They call his number once more.
That'll be a great offense. You got to be able to do a couple things that counters what the defense is going to do. Catch them off guard. One way to do it, run a draw play. They're thinking pass. You go with a run, and it picks up good yards.
When you played in the Super Bowl, Super Bowl 21 MVP, it was gigantic there in Pasadena. Is it bigger now today?
Yeah, the game is just much bigger now, Jim, because more people are watching it. The press that covers it, TV, it's around-the-clock analyzation of the game, and it's all about winning. You must win the Super Bowl to get credibility from the fans and the media. It's not fair, but that's just the way it is.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. The Broncos defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Panthers have it at the 24. Line to the left. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Games in the NFL can hinge on third and short. Who can pick them up and who can stop them? How about that play that time by the defense? They stopped the third short run, and now it's fourth down.
The Panthers lining up now for this field goal attempt. Ooh.
The kick is good.
You always want to be rewarded for a nice drive in a football game, even when it's a field goal, because you've made a lot of good plays, you've executed them, you got yourself in position to get some points, and that field goal just reinforces everything.
Broncos back deep, ready to receive. Bolden's not going to test the coverage this time as he takes a knee. The Panthers' defense would like to repeat what it did the last drive, not being out there too long, just three plays forcing a punt.
Well, they're going back out there. They're fresh, man. And the defensive line, the defensive front, they were awesome. That's why they got off the field so quickly.
First down at the 20. Anderson's handed the football. And that's a gain of 9.
Well, you can't knock them all down, and sometimes the running back has just got to break a tackle. Good job that time.
Second and short following the run. To Daniels. Tackle's made and the first down is picked up.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
Peyton Manning will be taking this one from the gun. From the gun. Owen Daniels makes the catch. Reception number 2 for him.
That's a good job by the quarterback. He read the defense. Nothing open deep, so he throws it short, and it puts him in great position for a second down play call.
After that grab, it's now second down and 2. Standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with 2 hands.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Tim. It also gives them a chance for 3 more downs.
First down here. The quarter is about to end. One more play first. Takes it from the strong eye. Thompson's in on the tackle. The first quarter comes to a close, and we're seeing a low-scoring defensive battle. We'll be back after this.
Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back here in the second quarter, defense ruled the first. And what are we going to see here, you think, in the second quarter, Phil?
Well, I think the first thing they got to do, Jim, is just believe in what they did all week long and preparing for the game. All the practices, all the film sessions, and just know sometimes it takes more than one quarter to get the answer. So stay with your game plan and see if you can find a way to make it work.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. This is third down. The Broncos will set up. The 44 is the first down line. Manning out of the gun. Manning finds Thomas.
Well, as you saw that receiver make the catch, I'll just say this. You cannot throw the football enough his way. There's no such thing. When in doubt, you don't like anything, turn and find him and throw it to him.
Manning's now completed four in a row. From the red zone. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Manning from the gun. Thomas has got it on a pass, has some heat on it. Marquette down for another reception.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Manning with the give. That's Keekly flying in to make the tackle. The Panthers go with the dime formation here on defense. Second and goal from the 7. Cortland Finnegan with the interception.
This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense, and finally, he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
Stewart's ready for the start of this drive. And so far, Phil, he hasn't posted any kind of totals we expect to see from him on the ground.
It's amazing they're winning this game. They're getting overpowered up front. The offensive line's having an awful day. That's why the running back is struggling so much to get yards. And if this continues, I promise you, they're going to lose today.
Real tough starting spot here for the offense. Newton's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Got drilled as he throws it. After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Newton, handoff. Stewart's tackled down after a gain of 2. The Panthers have the lead right now, but you would think to keep that lead, they'll want to lean on the running game a little bit more. Stewart struggled to find running lanes in this one.
I think you're right. I think they need to lean on this running game a little bit more. The offensive line has to block better. And sometimes you got to look at the running back and go, you got to break some tackles and make it happen.
Newton in shotgun formation. Heaving it down the field. Clutch catch. Talib's going to make the tackle.
tight spiral with the best of them. We saw it on that throw.
You said it right. Cam Newton can really spin the football, and that's always important because that means you can have some accuracy. It makes it easy for wide receivers to catch it also down the field, and he has strength. What a beautiful throw that time down the field.
First down, offense readying for the snap. Here's the first snap after the big play. Jonathan Stewart with the football. Stewart's tackled down at the 38. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Of scrimmage is the 38-yard line. The Broncos lined up in the nickel.
Second down and 10. He's going to get another carry. Stewart's the one who brings him to the ground.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up.
The Panthers are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. From the gun. Incomplete. The hit jarred the ball loose.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
This will be a field goal attempt from 49 yards out. The field goal attempt is good. It's good.
Jim, they get the field goal at that time, and it keeps the momentum on their side. It's positive energy. It makes you feel good. Now we'll see if the defense can carry it on.
The Panthers getting ready for the kickoff. Caldwell's going to start his return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Here's Sanders getting set to start this next possession. He's been off his game in this first half, Bill.
Yeah, it's been an awful game all around, but the star wide receiver is having an absolute terrible day so far. And if they want to win, he better pick it up, find ways to get open, and hope this quarterback gets him the football.
The Broncos will look to get set. Been a close game so far. The score's 6-0.
First down at the 24. Anderson's got it on the handoff. And we've reached the 2-minute warning. All right, so now as we go back to the field, we've got a good game going, and an offense is trying to close the gap before halftime. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Manning's ready for the snap, empty backfield. He'll take the snap from the gun, and it's complete over to Owen Daniels.
third catch today so far.
Managing that clock, such a big deal in the NFL. That's why they're hurrying up. Don't use that
pass. It is intercepted. He's got a wide open alley. A foot race to the, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
When a defense intercepts a pass like that and scores a touchdown, boy, does that give them hope. Gives them a lot of confidence. They really get the momentum on their side, and it's going to be hard for the offense to come out here and do anything after that play.
Now they come out for the point after. Of course, this year, the new rule, the PAT is snapped from the 15-yard line, making the point after 13 yards longer than the pass, a 33-yard point after attempt. The Broncos back deep, ready to receive. Bolden's got it. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Broncos offense has been nowhere in sight here for quite a while. Three consecutive drives that have come away empty. What about it, Phil?
That is the old phrase, MIA. They are definitely missing in action because there's no action on the offensive side. It's time for the quarterback to call the right plays and help his team out and get this thing moving.
Manning's got no one behind him. Just the quarterback waiting for the snap. The Broncos from the 27. Ball is out. This one's going back the other way.
Jim, a lot of times a coach, they'll put up with one fumble, but after that, your rear end might be on that bench. So learn from it and don't do it again.
The Panthers didn't have much to show for in the first quarter, but now they're trying to distance themselves right before halftime.
Well, you know, Jim, it's like this. You just keep fighting. It's like when you play golf and you start out with six or seven bogeys. You hang in there because you know sooner or later you're going to make a par.
We have a review coming from the booth. So they're looking to see if the ball came out before the knee was down.
I think when you look at these plays, most of the time it's pretty easy to determine. Jim, you know, it's just always a clear shot. When that knee hits the ground, you can freeze that shot and determine if it's a fumble or down by contact.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they took a second look, but the play on the field will stand. What a place to start for the offense. The Panthers at the line of scrimmage, split backfield. First down at the 25. Stewart's the receiver on the screen. Stewart's tackled down after a gain of 12.
Still, this time it's a halfback screen. Nice job by the quarterback. The halfback, good job after catching it, picked up some good yards.
It's first down as they head to the line.
The Broncos defense now is going to go nickel. Newton's got it in the gun. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
Olsen's one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
Going to be a penalty here.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Players from both sides making an appeal, but the officials saw it on the defense. Second and five coming up. Newton's going to take it from the gun. Powers his way across. Touchdown. And that touchdown figures to have them in a very comfortable spot heading into the halftime break.
Ooh, they are feeling good. There's no doubt about that. It's been a show of good offense here so far in the first half. And now what you got to do, halftime comes, you got to go in there and tell yourself to keep this going and keep the pressure on.
The Panthers for the extra point. He made it. The Broncos, I'm sure, wanted to avoid giving up points on that drive just before the half. But now they'll have even a bigger hole to dig themselves out of in this one. The score's 20-0. Getting set to kick it away. Bolden's got a chance for a return. And it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Panthers have been wreaking havoc on the defensive side of the ball today, Phil.
Yeah, right from the start of this game, Jim, we saw on the defensive side how emotional they were. And sometimes when you're that emotional, it makes you faster, and that's caused a lot of turnovers.
The Panthers with a nickel look here on defense. Peyton Manning from the shotgun. The reception by Daniels. Gets about 9 on the play. The Broncos signal for the timeout. And that's the first one they've used. After the catch, it's now second down and 1. Manning's alone in the backfield. From the shotgun to Daniels. And Daniels is marked down at the 41. The offense stops the clock right away with a timeout. Offense ready to play after calling a timeout. they come to the line, and it's first down. Manning's back in shotgun formation. Got hit on release. Coming up, second down. The Panthers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Manning's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Has it right on the sideline, inbounds. That's his first reception today.
This is a route that's not run enough in the NFL. The corner route, so many times, receivers just go across the field, they go short. But when you make these double moves like that, you get wide open, and what a throw by the quarterback.
Just 30 seconds to go before halftime and a first down. First down at the 42. Going deep, looking for Demaryius Thomas, and it falls incomplete.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Breaking huddle coming to the line at the 42. Second and 10. And Jared Allen is in on the sack.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
So they get to the quarterback on that last play. Third down coming up. The Broncos come to the line. First down marker is at the 32. Manning out of the gun. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down.
The Broncos put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
They're set to punt it away now. No chance to return this one as that punt is headed to the sidelines. The Panthers have been firing on all cylinders offensively in the first half, and they find themselves in excellent shape as we near halftime.
Oh, man, they are in good shape. I love what they're doing on the offensive side, and don't change anything. Go in there at halftime, pat those offensive guys in the back and say, keep it going. I think they will.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 30. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. Trevathan that time on the tackle. That'll do it for the first half. We'll be sending you to Larry Ridley back in our studios as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's get ready now to take a look back at the first half. The Panthers are happy to be in front right now and just want to play two more solid quarters. The Broncos didn't play their best, and they'll need to be at their best now to come back. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Broncos have it at the 7. Manning's got to rush the throw, and it's intercepted. Finnegan's in position, and he's the one who comes away with the ball. Now to late in the second. Here the defense will come up with the pick. Panthers would then turn it around for the touchdown, which takes the lead to 13. Staying late in the half. Davis got the grab, but fumbles here, and that connection will lead to a gain of 49 yards. Offense on the field now after the fumble, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 8-yard line. So that will bring our halftime report to a close. Let's go back now to Jim and Phil at the Super Bowl.
All right, Larry, thank you for that from the studios and halftime. We're going to transition now. We're about to get the third quarter underway. Broncos are ready to kick it away. The second half is underway now. Are we going to see a comeback for the ages? That's what it's going to take. The Broncos defense had a rough go of it in the first half, Phil, and let's see what they can do now to start the second half.
Well, they got manhandled. They got beat up. They got pushed around. I mean, let's toughen up and change things around.
The first snap of the second half. Ward's all over that offense and brings him down. The Panthers lead right now, but you will see that not everything is going their way. Stewart's had a tough one, especially down the stretch. If they want to control the game, you have to think they're going to go back to him for some more touches and try to get it right.
That's right. Keep giving him the football. Keep mixing the plays up. Don't get obvious in your play calls. If you do, the defense will have everything on their side.
The Broncos defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Second down and a long way to go. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
This is a tough situation for the offense, third and long coming up, but it's a good situation also. You're leading the football game, so there's no reason to take a chance and turn this football over.
On the way, third down. From the gun, Newton makes the reception. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
It's third long. Nobody open down the field, so the quarterback does the only thing he can do, throw it short.
All set to punt here. Off the hit. Mayo's there to make the tackle. And a run back of about 5. The Broncos have seen this game just get away from them. As it continues to get worse, they've still got more than a quarter to play.
Well, look, it's been a good learning experience, and you realize how tough this game is. So learn what you're doing here in this last bit of the game and see if you can carry that over into your next contest.
First down at the 33. Incomplete as Manning is off target on that pass. The Broncos take it from the 33.
Well, this third long, I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
It's third down coming up. Manning comes out in the pistol. Two hands on the football and has the catch. And now we'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Number. He does it this time. It works. Good call by Peyton Manning.
Coming to the line at the 49. First down here after the completion. Manning standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. To the sideline and complete. That's another reception. Give him two.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone, or a seven route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
Coming to the line at the 33. First and 10. Manning's going to be in the pistol here. Second down and 10. Anderson's taking the handoff.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
Scrimmage, the 34. The Panthers lined up in the nickel. Manning's got it in the gun. He's drilled as he throws.
The Broncos don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
He'll try this one from 51. The kick, and it's through there. The kick is good.
That was a good hold, good kick, 3 points. Good job by the offense.
The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. Whitaker drops to a knee
to the 20.
Ware's got to know as he takes the field here that this defense is running out of time to turn the tide of this game and start making things happen out there.
Well, I don't like to second guess, but I'm going to do it right here now. I don't think it's the defensive player's fault. I think the coaches have called a terrible game, and they got to put their players in better spots.
Isn't that what you put down as an occupation on your tax return? Second guesser?
Second guesser, yes.
That's what you do for a living.
And I get paid well.
But you hate the second guess in this case. Cam Newton takes a look down from under center. First down at the 20. Launches it down the field. Intercepted. And he's brought to the ground. The defense has some fight in them, even though this game's probably out of reach.
Well, they do. They got some pride. That's what it takes. That's why you're in the league. You're a good player who has pride, and you never give up. The defense didn't do that. They went out there and got the interception. And I'll say this to the offense. Let's keep playing. We'll see what happens late in this game.
The Panthers have displayed a phenomenal defense here today, and I think you would agree, Phil, that's the reason they're in position to win this game.
Yeah, the defense has been incredible. So aggressive. So full of emotion, running around. Every time you see a tackle, there's like seven or guys on the defensive side around the ball carrier. So that's awesome defense. That's why they're winning this game here so far today.
The football sits at the 42-yard line. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. First down at the 42. Running room. That's a gain of seven.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and two to go after the running play. Anderson's going to take the handoff now. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice. You get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
First down at the 15. Can't hold on here as this falls incomplete.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
Set up now at the 15. Second and 10. And it's batted down.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets in position, down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
Has his target. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Good job by the defense that time. They play smart. Third long, cover the deep receivers, make the quarterback throw it short on third and long.
Yes.
chip shot here. No doubt about it. Put three on the board.
Now the defense is going to be excited. They come out there. The offense has great field position, but they stop them. But they give up 3 points, but still a victory for the defense.
Broncos getting set for the kickoff. And no return here, so Newton will start this drive from the 20. The Panthers are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Bill.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You got to go out there and be much better.
First down at the 20. Jonathan Stewart with the football. Marshall's able to read that play and make the hit.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
And now they'll try over again on second down. Stewart lined up as the single back. Quick drop back. And Ward almost picked it off.
Look up at that scoreboard. You're leading the football game. So we have a third and long situation. So you've got to know that. Manage the game. Don't take a chance.
They face third down after the incomplete pass. And he's going to be sacked. So, just 3 plays and out for the offense.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing, they're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
The Panthers have to punt the football. Sanders got it now. Finnegan's there to take it down. That return's good for about 5. The Broncos took a while to get into a groove offensively in this game, but man, is it humming here in the second half.
Yeah, what a difference. My gosh, they were embarrassing in the first half how they played. Nothing was going right. Halftime, though, they turned it around, and now this is awesome to watch.
One more snap, and that'll end the quarter. Searching for space to the right, and that's a gain of 9. One quarter to go, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway.
Second and one on the way. Manning's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Makes the catch. That's his third catch of the day.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
Defense now is going to go nickel. The Broncos will take the snap from the 40. Owen Daniels makes the catch.
Quarterbacks love throwing the football on first down. Usually it's the easiest defense to throw against. They do a nice job that time. They get some good yards, and it's almost the first down.
After that grab, it's now second down and two. Manning's lining up in the pistol. And the reception by Anderson. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Manning's now completed four in a row. Coming to the line at the 27. First down and 10. C.J. Anderson with the catch.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Loss of three on the play. Quarters formation here for the defense. The Broncos will take the snap from the 30. It's intercepted!
Such an impressive athlete. We know he can tackle and stop the run game, but how about that in the pass game? Defending the pass and picking it off. Good job.
The Panthers haven't had a very productive drive in quite a while here, Phil. Do they need to switch things up to get this train rolling again?
Absolutely. Switch it up. Switch up the play call. Show some different formations. Try to catch the defense by surprise. If you do that, that's going to greaten your chances of having success.
Two tight ends on the field here. First down at the 28. Stewart's going to secure the handoff. Stewart's met after a gain of 8. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
That's second down coming up. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. He'll pick up 7 this time.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The Panthers come out with a split backfield. He'll take the snap about midway through the fourth. Now,
they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The ball is spotted at the 49.
Second down, two to go.
Here's the handoff. Stewart's all over the ball carrier.
The Panthers offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Third and four coming up. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun.
Reaches out and grabs it. And now we reach the two-minute warning. Back now in this one, and time is running out here in the fourth quarter. They're in punting formation. This punt will not be returned. It will never see the field of play as it sails out of bounds. The Panthers have victory within their reach now, and they've only turned up the heat as we've gotten into the fourth quarter, Phil.
And, you know, listen, they're doing this against a very good offense, so that makes it even more impressive to play this well against a good offense. What an outstanding day by the defense.
First down, pressure on every snap now. The Panthers had at the line, dime package. First down at the 30. And it's complete over to Owen Daniels. That picks up seven. That's reception. Number seven for him.
Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the playoff. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football. That was an incomplete pass that time against cover two. The two deep safeties in. Really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
A huge third down play on the way. Manning's ready for the snap, empty backfield. Snap it out of the gun. There is a flag out.
Holding offense.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. This is a crucial third down play coming up. Third and 12 to go. And that's going to be a three and out.
The Broncos really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Going for it on fourth down. Back at the line. They're going for it on fourth. The Broncos from the 27. And Dan Williams has got the catch and the first. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout.
And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. The Broncos have it at the 39. And the reception by Anderson. Then picks up about three.
Well, when you see a play like this by the offensive player, that is a great reflection on the coach. You can tell they've gone over these situations. When you're fighting the clock and you can get out of bounds, get it done. Good job by the offensive player there.
Play number six coming up on this drive. With about a minute to go, they're going to need every break possible. First, they must score on this possession. And he comes down. No, the defender tips it out.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The Panthers with a nickel look here on defense. Third and seven. Launching it deep. This will be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
The quarterback is going to hate himself tomorrow when he watches this tape, because you only get a chance for big plays in the NFL about three or four times a game. That one just went by.
They're going to go for it here on fourth and seven. They'll go for it on fourth down, late stages. The Broncos snap it at the 36. Caldwell's there to catch. Touchdown in the late stages. And even after that touchdown, they're going to need a miracle in the closing moments.
Well, I think what we're finding out, the game is never over. Play it till the end. They did a great job of scoring there. Now can they find a way to get that football back and maybe win this game?
The Broncos for the point after. Makes the PAT. Manning's going to watch his defense come out here in a moment. He was good for over 70 passing yards on that last touchdown drive. Broncos hoping to recover now, an onside kick.
Well, they had a lot of options to choose from in the onside kick there, because I've seen them in practice do many different onside kicks, but the attempt was just not good, and they're probably going to lose the game now.
The Panthers' offense is on the field, and they are sitting pretty with the lead late in this game, Phil.
I like the way they are sitting in this game. You said it, Jim, and I'll tell you what, all the pressure goes to the defense. Can the defense find a way to get them off the field three downs and out and make them punt?
First down coming up. Of the eye. Here's the handoff. Where's the one who made the big stop? The Broncos will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. coming to the line at the 44. Second down and 12. Jonathan Stewart with the football. The Broncos stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. Following that timeout, defense back out on the field. After that run, third and 8 for the offense. They'll go ground. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Broncos will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. After that timeout by the defense, play is ready to resume. They're set to punt it away now. And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. And this, it would seem, is the possession that will decide this football game. This is the guy right here who lives for a moment like this.
Oh, he does. This moment, think about this offense, how much talent this quarterback has. And they have an offense that's so diverse. They have so many plays. I feel sorry for the defense in a situation like this.
First down. Pressure on every snap now. Manning's going to take it from the gun. C.J. Anderson with the catch. Taken down, and the clock continues to be their enemy right now.
I think what you find out about your offensive lineman, what kind of shape they're in, it's late in the game, you have no timeouts, you got to go to this hurry-up offense. Let's see if they can make it work.
Broncos head to the line and out of timeouts. The Broncos take it from the 33. Down the field. Fourth down is on the way, and to the surprise of no one in this stadium, they're going for it.
Yep, and you know who's going to win this battle? The toughest, most physical team. That's what the NFL is all about.
The Broncos, last snap. Let's see what they can do here. Crucial play here. Fourth down on the way. The Broncos take it from the 33. Looking at every option. And it's going to fall incomplete. For the first time ever, the Carolina Panthers have won the Super Bowl. The Lombardi Trophy is heading to Charlotte, North Carolina. It was a storybook season that ends with a Super Bowl victory today. And I think when you go back to the beginning of training camp, it was a storybook season that ends today. And I think when you look back to the beginning of training camp, no one would have imagined that this team would be holding up the Lombardi Trophy in the end.
I think we're seeing a new day and age in the NFL. Well, let's quit trying to guess who's going to win before the season, because
the talent is so good across the board in the whole league, but it's when you get hot. And this team got hot late in the year. That was enough to get them into the playoffs, and they made it work all the way through to a Super Bowl victory.
The brotherhood will never be stronger than this moment. All the dreams coming out of youth. The emotion of it all, it's almost overwhelming. To realize a dream from the playgrounds, through all the practices, to one day have your hands on the Lombardi Trophy. And now that moment is realized. For the rest of your life, you'll be remembered as a Super Bowl champion.